Welcome. Here is a common problem, a quick solution, and detailed explanation. The problem is this. I have some simple raw data. I'm going to create a pivot or pivot table from it. Let's have total sales by putting sales in value area. The moment I put product, it does give me the report, but instead of the word product, row labels comes. Nobody likes it. And most of us get irritated and then we type it manually. The problem seems to have gotten solved temporarily. If I put something else there, it'll continue to show product. And probably we already know that is going to happen. So that's extra effort to change it every time. So obviously, this is not the right solution. Here is the quick solution. Click inside the pivot table, go to design tab, go to report layout, choose tabular form. And problem is solved. Now, if you put another item, it will work as expected. Done. If you really want to know why this happens, just continue for a few more minutes. The idea is this. Tabular form means every field. Field means a column from raw data occupies one physical column. So if I add one more field, product, that will go in column B. And because there's a hierarchy now, there's location first and then product, the location will not repeat. There'll be blank spaces and then there'll be products. And then the value area means the calculations will shift one more column. If I add a third column, another physical column is used. So the width of the pivot table grows very quickly and beyond a point, you can't see the calculations. To avoid this from happening, what we needed is a compact form. So that compact form should reduce the wastage of space horizontally as well as vertically. And that is why report layout compact form was created. Now, it doesn't matter how many fields you put in row area, physically, it'll occupy only one column. So now we have main field, subfield, and the subtotal. So this is how compact mode works. Tabular mode works in a different way. Both of them come in separate columns, empty space, and the main one is shown as subtotal here. And there is another one called outline, which is similar to tabular. The only thing is that total row, which was wasting space, is now gone because along with the main one, the total comes above rather than below. So these are the three variations. Now you know which one to use when. There is another common problem. Often we copy all this and paste it as values. And when you do that, these empty things are going to be a problem for you. You'll have to fill the gaps, which is a manual process. Don't do that. In pivot table itself, there is a solution. You go to design, report layout, repeat all item labels, and that's done. Now you can copy paste, come back and remove the repetition. In case of reports which are complex, sometimes visually it becomes too crowded. So it's a good idea to put banded rows so that correlating numbers and text becomes easier. If you want further separation, then there is a blank rows option here. Insert blank line after each item. This gives you some breathing space. And in case this was a printout, it also gives some area to write your comments. The last thing I want to tell you is, default is compact mode. So every time you create a pivot table, you'll have to manually shift from compact to tabular mode. We don't want that. Of course, Microsoft has thought of this. We want to change the way Excel behaves. And that is done in file options. File options, data, edit, default layout. And here you can change it from compact to tabular. Every setting you can think of in pivot table context is available here. For example, many people like classic mode. Change it here, click OK, and all future pivot tables will follow tabular and classic. If you want to learn more about pivot tables, I have a detailed course on that. The link is given in the description. Let me know if you like it. See you next time. Thank you.